Okay. So what all steps we have mentioned? First step is actually creating the private key. So we are discussing how to configure HTTPS website. So first step is to create a private key. Second step is generate CSR. CSR is certificate signing request. Okay, from the key, private key. Now third one is generate certificate. See, this is the certificate from CSR. Okay, so this is the three steps that we are going to do. Okay, there is one default command. You try to by heart, but at least you learn what I am doing. So using a OpenSSL, I am creating a request for new key RSA with number of bytes 2048 letters will be there. For that I am creating RSA key for nodes, and what is output is a key output. And why your key output is key dot temp. That's a temp file, that's a 2048 file. And the protocol of your SSL, all protocol, this is a standard means is a normally we call the SSL standard is X509 is a standard for all in every case, because it doesn't depend upon Linux or Windows. X509 is the standard for all, universal. And how many days we require? One second. How many days we require the certificate? That is what we are checking. So using this key, it will generate a key, and using this certificate, using this command, it will generate the certificate. Okay, we'll try this, and the output is given to certificate.temp file. This is so simple command. We'll execute it in one of the server. He was trying to log into one of the server. So we'll execute that command. Try to use the command. Copy paste. So all comes here. Certificate signing, request creation, everything on a single line. So this is how you. This is a byte. we have several other trials. So I will create one certificate. Certificate is with country, India. And by giving India, state province, maybe Karnataka, okay, locality. This is, I'm creating self sense template, okay. For example, it is maybe SMTech. Okay. And session unit, training session. Okay. And the common name. Common name is the certificate name. It's the domain name. So you purchase certificate for a domain. So previously I created for Vivek.com, right? So I may create for Vivek.com. So that is it. Enter. Yes. You need to provide these details to them also. That is the reason why we are creating CSR. Here we are directly creating the certificate. Okay. We can give some AFB.com. Some doesn't matter. So that is done. So you have the certificate.com and key.com. You can just scat it out. So if you have that one. End private key, start with the begin private key. These are the letters, 2400 letters will be there. Okay, next, you can get the certificate also. So this is a certificate. So you can verify this certificate using OpenSSL command. OpenSSL X509, okay, minus in, you need to give the certificate.mfile minus no out, minus text will give you the output regarding the certificate. This is a certificate. Okay, so it will give you all encryption. So India, Karnataka, Bengaluru, BesanTech, OU training, and my domain is Vivek.com. This common name is the certificate name. Okay, so it can be installed only for Vivek.com. Getting over? So you have seen this tile somewhere else also. You take gmail.com. You can click on this one, certificate valid. You open this, you get the details. See, US, California, Google LLC, that is a organization. Common name, see mail.google.com, that is a common name for gmail.com. Okay, so these the same details is there with our. Here also one more good point. So we have generated for 365 days, right? See now, it is created on November 4 and it will expire on, not before. Yes, number of days we can reduce. In the command, first command, yes, first command you can reduce. Okay, it can be 2 years also. So this is also a perfect, strong certificate, but this certificate is not, known by any browsers in the world because they are not validated. Someone has to certify, no? You are an authorized person. So that certificate is given by the provider, and for that only they will charge. Ready? For SSL, you have to, for their rapid SSL is there. For rapid SSL, you can get for 1 year 1,500 rupees one SSL certificate. When you go for multiple encryption certificates, it goes up to 1 lakh for single certificate for 1 year. Getting the point? So it depends on the certificate, how they are using the encryption. So more encryption will increases, your certificate cost also increases. Yes.
So I have a
Yeah.
So I created a certificate.
Correct.
Like,
yes.
So I want to clear with them, or sometimes they will provide the
SSL will be provided by the provider. You can use what is created here. But what happens is that it will give you a warning when you access the website and tell that this is not authorized. You can click on that one, it will become authorized.
Yeah,
because you are telling that.
Add exception.
Add exception will come. So add exception is just giving the browser that I am a valid person. Okay. See, in this one, this color will be different. In Chrome, it will come correctly. Red will be done, green will be done.
Yes. Yeah.
Got it, na? So that is the case. So otherwise, it will not be green. It is something else. Okay, to make it green, we can allow it. Okay, so we'll do that. So now certificate is generated, key is generated. Using these two values, we will be able to configure our website. I will try to install. So for Apache, there is NodeSSL should be installed for Apache in order to Apache to communicate with the certificates. The certificate is created by OpenSSL, right? So there should be some module. Yesterday I was telling about modules, right? So NodeSSL is a module of OpenSSL so that you can read the certificates and encrypt and decrypt. So NodeSSL is required. You need to try if you install NodeSSL. Mod and iPhone or underscore. Yeah, it is underscore. So it is already there. Okay? Some error is there. No? First search it and then we will install. Okay? EM search mod underscore SSL. Mod underscore SSL. So there is one mod SSL is there. By default, there will be SSL. If you want to check it, you can check that also. How many modules are there? HTTPD and yeah, pipe grep minus I SSL. So it is not there. We need to install mod SSL. Okay. So for that, we need to find out where exactly is the mod SSL. Otherwise, SSL will not work. Okay, we'll try with without this one and check if it is available. Many other. Mm-hmm. Yes, mod 24 SSL. No, sorry. Mod 24 SSL. So this is the one. So in EM install, mod 24 SSL. So it will install perfectly. Now SSL is installed. Now if you can check in the MySQL SSL module is shared. What my point? So after installing mod SSL, SSL module is shared module. Now you can install your certificate. So now how to install your certificate? I will let you in Apache. Now go to Apache's location /etc/httpd/conf.d where my configuration is there. So by default, there is a configuration called ssl.configuration. Okay, it contains, it listen, see, listen, there is there. Previously, listen is there, 80. Then this is 443. So all logs will be there, passphrase logs will be there in this particular location, /etc/libxf/passdialogs. Okay, you need to worry about more. SSL cache is there. All this SSL, when you click on that one, it will be stored in cache, in server cache. How much time it will use that SSL caching? 300 seconds. Okay, divided by 60, 5 minutes. 5 minutes it will store. And main thing that comes is, yeah, SSL virtual host. So whenever you create a virtual host for 80 port number, you need to create for 443 also. Same, ditto copy. Ditto copy, there your, this won't change. Document root won't change. Server name won't change. It will be same. Only the parameter related to SSL should be there. SSL engine must be on. Okay, SSL engine must be on. These all things you can omit. Only three parameters we require. Yeah. SSL certificate file. So SSL certificate file is a location where it fetches the certificate. There is one more file, SSL certificate key file. So these two are enough for working a particular website in SSL. So we will configure vivek.com here for same thing. Okay. So vivek.com.conf. So how was the virtual host configured? Virtual host. Use tab 80. If you don't know the IP. We need to set up both. We need to set up both. This is I insert firstly. Virtual host closed. What all parameters should be there? Server name. Server name. Make.com. Document. Okay. And document root is var www.html. Okay, better create and use it. Mkdir create it. We'll create one file index.html. Okay, in which we will give So now website is ready. Apache CDL restart. You can restart it and access that website. What is that website URL? We'll configure vivek.com. Okay. In our local host. Host file. So I have an IP address. Copy to crypto. Slash etc. This is the new one. Okay. We'll access that one. Okay. I need to access HTTPS. That is what I was trying to do. Now go to the tab. In the same vivek.com, you can have your SSL. That is always better. It's virtual host. .443. Okay. Is it virtual host? These two things never change. Server name, document root should be same. Engine must be on. Certificate file. You should give the location and then certificate key file. You should give the location. So we will find the location first. Okay. Normally, all etc SSLs are loaded into /etc SSL. /etc SSL, there is a location where you find the certs. Okay. But it's not required like that, it should be here. Okay. But I will create here itself how /etc SSL and for HTTPD. Okay. This is the location I created. And I copy from my local where my certificate is there. See, two pen server, pen to /etc SSL HTTPD. I copy this to my location. Better if you always change this name. Okay. Why? Because there will be multiple SSLs if you are configuring. Always give a name that is apt. So I will give like this key. I will name the key name as vivek.com or vivek.com or key dot pen. Okay. And I change the certificate name to vivek.com.crt. It should be CRT. So I will name it as CRT. This is also fine. Or if you want to give PEM also, that is also fine. Whichever. There is a normally a convention for certificate, extension should be ERT, and for key, the extension may be .key. Okay, but not necessary. You can give anything. So better I will change that. Rebate.com key.pem to rebate.com.key. Okay. So what is my key location? pwd/etcssl rebate.com. Okay, sorry. Rebate.com.key. This is the first file. Okay, open that configuration /etc/httpd/conf.d/rebate.com.com. Go to, this is a key file, right? Put it here. Okay, same thing, instead of key, it is CRD. Because we have named it like CRD. Right. Now again, open it file. So this is the configuration file. Now we will check if there is a syntax error or not. How to find the syntax error in Apache? Reload is down dot here. Before reloading, you need to find the syntax error. I told you yesterday. What is it? Apache CTL minus T. Will give you syntax. Syntax is okay. Okay. Apache CTL restart. Restart. Now check netstat minus NTPL. 443 should be there. Okay. So after installing Node SSL and restarting Apache, Node SSL will come up. Now we have set up certificate for viewing. Now we'll try to access it with using HTTPS. It should give the same output. It will give you a warning. Okay. See, not secure. It's not secure. Your connection is not private. So what we will do? We'll go to private and proceed with unzip. It will protect. You got it. Even though this is HTTPS, you are getting output. Only thing is that this is, we are giving not secure. Why? Because browser does not know whether the certificate is valid or not. Okay? That is the reason why certificate is invalid they are given. But the details will be there. See, Vivek.com certificate is not trusted. Trusted means what? It is not certified by the SSL provider. Okay? Like GoDaddy, VeriSign, Insta, and n number of things, Rapid SSL, are the different providers. If they are not certified, means our certificate will be invalid. Okay? But it doesn't mean that this is not secure. This is secure only. Okay? But it doesn't know, the browser doesn't, in the world, doesn't know about it. Yes, only that. Okay, normally the provider will give you one more certificate. This is normal CRD. Okay, they will provide you one CA, certificate authority. Why this is required? Certificate authority is the, who is the provider? They have their own certificate. What happens is that whenever you access a website, it will query to the authority and ask whether this is valid or not and come back. It's a very fast. Okay, or then only the certificate will load. So we need to put this CRT and CE in a one file for this one. For Apache, we have a separate configuration for CA. We can give you CA certificate file, there is a directive is there. We can give the path, but in some in AWS SSL provider is there, LB there, LB in SSL provider, we need to file only one file. In that case, what we need to club this CRT and CA in one file and then upload. Nginx, you know, Nginx is a web server, okay, it's a proxy server, it also works with SSL. So what we need to do, we need to have this CA and CRT in a single file. So don't, CRT is the certificate for the domain. CA is the certificate for the provider. Okay, for the double check, for getting valid. For us, it is not required. See, all details will be there. If you click on details, INKA Bengaluru Besantech Training Vivek.com.
As it is.
DNS, that is provided by the registrar. Registrar itself has a provision to provide certificates. Okay. If you go to very simple, we'll see. We'll go to which is the best provider. GoDaddy is there. GoDaddy. See, they provide domains.
Yeah.
They provide websites. They provide web hosting. Hosting means what? You will get a location where you can upload your files. Your space will be given. For us means this is our server only. We will upload, we have space. Okay. So domains means you can search that domain. Suppose Vivek.com. If you want Vivek.com to be registered, search it. You will get .com for 399 rupees. So it's already taken and they are telling some few suggestions. So once this is done, you will get a authorization. You can like sign into it. Okay. Let me check if I can sign in. I will use it. SSL. We'll work like same. You need not to separate install SSL for your app, mobile app. It is only for the server. Mobile app, what it does is it have authentication to the servers. Okay, it does with SSL. In that case, we need to just provide the SSL URL only, valid certificate URL. It will authenticate itself, nothing else. This is one application. Okay, this is an application. So it is given like pariksha.digital. Okay, so this is actually a website. Okay, this is the website, means this is actually the website. This is the website. So this is already, if you are set it with SSL, it will show you the details. Okay, so this is the website that is having some courses and etc. are there. And this is created in an application called Moodle. So Moodle is an application. So Moodle application has a feature that they will provide you an app. Using app also you can connect to the website. Okay, same, you need to just provide the username and password. You will be logging in. Yeah. There is an Android app for Moodle. Moodle is an application. We provide an Android app. It has a Mac OS, iOS app also is there. Only thing is that it is uses some credentials that is just same like that of website. Only that is there because they work with APIs. From the Android app, it query a API and get the request. That is the reason how it works. So for an app, Android developer, they need not to think about what SSL and configure SSL. It just to communicate, their connection should be okay. That's it. Okay. If somebody tells that in your organization, app developer tells that your SSL is not connected. Two reasons are there. Either from his server, his system, SSL is not accessible. Some firewall problem. Next problem is that he is using some older version of Android utility. Older version of handling SSL. That is possible. He's developing some app using Appium or whatever. Okay, he's testing, even testing also, same thing. If they are using older version of SSL, because there are some SSL vulnerabilities that came into picture recently. They have hacked a website using SSL vulnerability. So what they did is that we need to change the SSL code. We need to change the certificates. There are a few versions of SSL. SSL version 1, version 2, version 3, like that. Okay, so version 1 and 2 are actually gone out of place. So whoever using version 1 and 2 got hacked. Okay,
what is that? Like, what is the volume they are don't bring us?
It's uploaded in the Apache server. That's okay. The same location. Just like your WAW, it's in some different locations.
Okay, we created
an index
from the Yes.
Everything is there. That's an application.
Video file or something.
Files will be there. Then we need to store it in some other externals. We can store it in remote. It will be a soft link. It can store in NFS also. NFS means whenever the video is called, because video have a location which is a NFS in LAN itself, so that we need not to waste the time, waste the storage in the current system. Yeah. Or it can be a separate only one, so that is also possible. Okay. So there are many number of ways you can store your videos and all, so that it won't get exhausted. Okay. If you are considering, if you are creating a website for YouTube, just like YouTube, yeah. YouTube is completely dealing with videos. Yeah. Okay. How they are streaming it. So for the streaming, we need to have a streaming service. Streaming service means what? Which can handle more bandwidth. So more bandwidth should be allocated for your websites. That is done by the service provider. Who? The server provider. Where the server, physical server is there, no? They will provide you bandwidth. This is the line how you can 101 terabyte, 150, whatever the bandwidth size is. According to that. And according to your capacity, your memory should be high. Your CPU should be high. Because of a streaming server, it's mandatory that the resources should be in the high. The Xeon server. No, that's all. Considering Apache, it is nothing different. I just have a location, I can fetch the video from there. That's
all. Imagine, for
example. Yes, Android.
No. Yeah, same thing. Right?
Yeah. Yeah, mostly that link only. See, in the same case, suppose you are creating that video is actually a course site, LMS, learning management system. Okay, so same like in Besant also, they will provide some YouTube link in the site.
Yeah.
If you click on that, it will go to YouTube. That is only link actually. Or you can play it in the same jargon also. That is also fine. But it doesn't take the bandwidth of the current system. It will take a few, but it will be of the YouTube. Suppose if you want, you are on tube. Means that is an application, flash application installed in your system. Your application, your web server will refer it. You will write in code to run it using Shockwave or some applications. For the client, it should have some plugins, Java plugins or some other plugins to run it. That's it. Okay. But it will have a link to, as it mentioned, it's a link to a video. It will have a video call or MP4, it will be connected. So that a person who clicks on this can be review the video in that page. Remember, if you want to get the recording, click on recordings. It will list the recording. Click on that to the complete subject. It will play the video. And it is not using any other's YouTube's. It is his own systems. So how to play this? This is playing means this is a frame now. This frame will be coded in such a way that it should play a video. Code is written for that. That's it. Nothing else. And it is fetched from that location. Just like you view this page, it is fetched from a location. Just like video also, it's fetched from a location. Okay?
That
we
should have
a
DNS
server
that
is
separate,
right? DNS servers should be separate. We can have it in one server also. No problem. You will get to know the DNS, how to configure. Okay. The same thing is done by the provider also. Depends. Not necessary if it's Windows or not. Somebody keeps it providers from the website provider itself. Somebody keeps it with their own, like Cloud 53 AWS. Yeah. Somebody keeps it with Azure 53 also. Whichever, no problem. So this is what the SSL is. To make it valid, you can have this certificate uploaded to the browser itself so that it makes it green. Now, yes, green, it will be green, otherwise it will be red. So now, sometime what happens is that your key may be different, your certificate may be different, but you want to validate that these two matches. What number? To validate these two, key and certificate should match. Otherwise, they won't encrypt. Because those are different means that's different. So they depends upon the hash tag. There is one hash key for both. They are similar. They should be similar. So how to find that one? This is one process for you. Normally, all administrators should know this. How to validate key and certificate. This is an interview question also. Okay, so we will do that. We will check that. There is a hashtag, you need to find it out. That hashtag is the output. There is another method is there, how to change this. There is my website called SSL Checker. SSL Checker or SSL Hopper is also there. SSL Checker. Online also this there are verify, how to verify this thing. But never ever use online methods. Do it from backend. Because they have some caching method. They tell that they won't cache it, but always we cannot believe it. So don't use this. These are critical. Because encryptions and SSLs are critical. Don't use it in online. Okay. So we will do it. We'll check. So there is an SHA hash sum key. We need to find that key. Then only we'll be able to find what hashtag is that. So first find out the hashtag of key and find the hashtag for certificates. Okay. So how to find it? Open SSL. Okay. Open SSL. First we will find for certificate. So what is the standard? X509. X509 is the standard. Give input certificate. Minus in. I'm in some other location. No, my certificate name is vivek.com.cit. Okay, and what should be our output? Minus pub key, or better, this is okay. When you type this one, you will get all these details. Huh? No output, minus text. It will give, right? It's not good. Let no out. Sorry, no out. So, if you want it in text file, minus text. Sorry, same command, minus text. Here you can bypass this one. This is common for all. This is the certificate. See, there is a signature here. Okay, this signature and the key signature will be same. Okay, SHA signature should be same. So we'll find that one first. So for that, no out should be there. Then minus public key. This is the public key. And we will use it with the SHA sum. There are n number of hashing methods are there. You can try with anyone. Okay, you can try with 256. Sum. Checksum. We'll call this as a checksum. No out is also fine, but key is not fine. Yeah, this is fine. Okay, same is the case with key open SSL. You need to give key file, open SSL, and there is no external client. We are not mentioning that. So in this, instead of that one, we will mention private key, p key minus in vivek.com.key, and no out. If you want to give no out, no output, and give SHA 256 sum. Both should match. Whether they are same? Whether they are same? They are same. Okay, they should match. Okay, so they are matching. They are matching means this key and the certificate are valid. SHA? Ah, yes. Encryption method. This is actually used for checksum. Checksum is actually validating something with key. Okay, we are not extracting the complete certificate. We are only a tag is there. Each and every key, there will be some hashtag. We call this a checksum. We will extract that. It is not necessary that you should output with the SHA, or you can have with any RSA also. It is there. If RSA is not there, use SHA. 256 or a simple SHM will use SHA A1 1H MAC. This is also one set of algorithm. All these are algorithms. Always use checksum. Where is that one? One checksum. SHA 1 sum. And also you will get this. Okay. And we'll go for certificate, expire outline. But always use the same for both. Why? Then only you need to match. Otherwise, you will get different. When you write a checksum, use the same checksum for all. See, both are same. This is how you validate a key and a certificate. So somebody asks you a question, how to validate a key certificate? This is the way. We don't use the command. We tell that we are finding the checksum, we are finding a hash code that is available in the certificate and the key. And they should match. If they are matching, they are perfect. You can use this certificate. You can take this key and certificate to any other server and run it. Okay? You have 5 servers are there. In the 5 servers also, you can use it. This is reusable. SSL certificate are reusable. Okay. Now, while we come to the certificate naming, there are two types of certificates. There are actually not two types, there are three types of certificates. First is the normal certificate, which is having common name certificate. Second is wildcard SSL. Wildcard SSL. So what is a wildcard SSL? Suppose www.vivek.com. I'm creating this website. I need a this one. What do you call SSL certificate for this? I have one more mail.vivek.com, and this is my mail server. I have another thing called db.vivek.com, which means SSL. And this is my database server. Here, what is difference? Only the subdomain. So, if I have a certificate star.vivek.com, it should apply for all. So, if you configure virtual host for www, mail, and db, you can use the single certificate. Single certificate for all. Get my point? So, that is for SSL is known as wildcard SSL. And the third SSL is we call as it's not CD, it is CNSSL. And what is the difference to CNSSL is? I'll give you the correct name. Suppose Gmail.com.
mail.google.com.
Are the domain same? Domain is different, right? This is gmail.com and this domain is google.com. But this can share a same SSL.
When you access gmail.com, when you access mail.google.com, it won't give you any error. It gives you the same certificate. Have you checked it?
Check it.
Always try like that. gmail.com. Enter. See, it goes to redirect to mail.google.com. And if you check the certificate of mail.google.com, valid certificate, it's mail.google.com. In some cases, we will log out this one. Sign out. Okay. See now, accounts.google.com. Okay, accounts.google.com. Sorry, gmail.com. We'll take gmail.com. Still, it is, sometimes it is, should not redirect. Even accounts.google.com. Check the valid certificate. And it is, see, it is star dot. See, it is star.google.com. So accounts.google.com is using wildcard SSL. Okay, mail.google.com is using normal SSL. But they can also use this star.google.com in accounts also. Accounts also, mail also. Since they are maintaining separate mail servers and account servers, they are maintaining separate SSL certificate. That is the reason.
Close.
Google.com. Take Google.com and check the certificate. It is star.google.com. Okay. In sometimes Google Co.in. Google.co.in. Check the certificate. Star.google.com. Here the domain is different, no? Star.google.com and this is Google Co.in. Two different domains. But they are using same SSL. How is it possible? So there is a possibility you can have such certificates. Okay. So who is the provider here for certificate? Its organization is LLC and the provider is Google Trusted Services only. Google itself has its own certificates. See, there is one more thing. Yes, this is, we call this a SAN certificate. S-A-N. SAN. Subject alternating names. So this certificate is used by how many domains? Google.com, Android.com, AppEngine.com, G.com. All these domains are configured in same star.google.com. So that is a SAN certificate. If you have multiple domains and the same SSL, then that we call as a SAN certificate. If we have same domain and multiple subdomains, this is called as a subdomain, right? And we call as wildcard SSL or a normal. There are three types of SSL. Okay. So don't forget that commands SSL key. Validating the keys that is related to Apache. So what are things that is related to Apache SSL? What is the configuration? We need to first generate the certificate. So
So what are the three steps for certificate in general?
Create a key.
Private key, CSR and
CSR.
Using CSR only, we will be able to create the certificate for the provider. Now we have created self-signed certificates. Okay? So we can create CSR also and then sign it up. That is also fine. So whenever you are in a company, they will require a CSR. So there is a command for creating. So you can just Google it out. You can write a create a CSR command. That's that. Only thing is that you need to use the latest keys. Keys means number of 2048, 4096, maximum number of keys. So that the encryption will be strong. That's it. Only thing that have a problem is CDN. CDN is content delivery network. What is the concept of content delivery network? No idea. You access Google here. Typically, we have to Google code.in. You go to UK. Code.uk will come. How does it render? How does it know it is UK and
here?
Touching goes wrong? No, that's a concept of CDN. Like that, this Google page is there in UK. This Google page is there in India. This Google page is there in America. Okay? Different geographical locations, this page is there. Okay? So, first, whenever you browse your domain or Google, it first searches which is the shortest path to this domain. So, if you are in UK, UK servers will be the shortest one, other than going to India, right? So it will access, go to the CDN server of UK and fetches back the UK. That is the idea. So what happens is that if you change the SSL, you should have to set the SSL in each and every service. That will take time.
That's not the problem.
It will route from the original traffic. If you don't have CDN, it will go to UK and come back. Normally, what they do is that all static files, you know, JSS, JavaScript files, CSS files, style sheet files, will be loaded to CDN. Because they should be cached at first. Those are caching servers. So we will be enabling caching in each and every server. Browser caching, we call as browser caching. So it will take only one, first time it will take more time to load the page. Next time it won't take much time. That's a random checkpoint. It doesn't give you a complete idea. You can get the complete idea only if it is in your local. It's local means your servers only, it will be the correct
topic. Yeah, in digital marketing, the
ranking of the website.
Yeah.
Now that ranking website is different. That is based on the searches that is done by different people. Suppose you are searching in Google,
yeah.
You are searching in Yahoo, you are searching in AltaVista. Wherever you are searching, if that domain is searched n number of times, that is in a central server. Getting? That is in a central searching search engine is there, where there is all data will be there. From there, it will pulse.
They are not accessing our server.
No, it is not accessing our server. Definitely not. Okay. It won't be like that. There is another case is there, if we have registered with Google Analytics and we have given that register our report to public. In that case, the others can get the details, right? This is a very popular website and we can select. Okay, that is possible. If they are, we are authorizing them to publish it, then it is there. Otherwise, so that is the concept of SSL. So you got the concept, right? To set it up or how to set it up. SSL. So
the creation of key is the only burden. Okay. Rest you can do. Don't remember. Save it somewhere. Use it every time because they won't change any time. Long back for 10 years I'm using the thing. It won't change. Okay. Why? Because it is not changing means they are all standards. Standard means they are base. Water is created out of hydrogen and oxygen. It will not change after 100 years also. Right? So that is a base. That is a concept. Sysadmins there is there. If you are working as a sysadmin, not like the systems repairing teams.
Yes, yeah.
No, the not that system. SysOps. We call that system operations.
Yeah.
Which you completely use for the architecture level.
Yeah.
They require this. They require this, they need to create. In DevOps, some DevOps also they are working this one. Some
that company that giving purchase something from so if they are providing the certificate.
But you have to configure, na? Who will configure the Apache? Who will configure the engines? You are the persons to do that. So you should know that. Clear? That's it. They are providing, they are providing, they don't configure. Configure, you must do.
But we can add that certificate to
Apache service. This is manual.
Game. Is there any command for that?
You want to use it or you want to create it as Google?
Not
there, there is no command, this is only, download it, it's a file, it's a zip file, they will provide a zip file. Upload this zip file to the server, unzip it, you will get CRT and that CSR and the key file will be there. Use only key and CRT files. You verify it using that command. That command you have to buy at. This OpenSSL, na? This one. This one. This is very simple. X509. In vivek.crt, no out, and minus text. Path minute to give the path. Instead of I'm going to that path and extracting it. Or you can give the path. It will give you the details of certificate. This is how you verify it, whether this certificate has expired or not. Sometimes what happens, many certificates are there in the location. You are first time you are going into a company and that you are on this team and you want to, they told you to configure new one. So looking into the servers, you are confused. There are n number of certificates are there. Which is the one I should use? So you need to verify it first. This is the only way you verify. Using this command, you need to verify everywhere, everything, and check the expiry, not after. This is where I will use the script. Script, not after. What it is? Okay. If there are n number of are there, you can just give in a for loop. And give it and see which is expired and which is not expired. At least you can find that. Okay. So this command you always remember. So this will give you an expiry details. Okay. Now, yesterday we have discussed regarding this one, right? Finding the count of. We will do right now.
Okay, because nobody has did it, I suppose. So where is the access log? Access log is there in tail manager var log httpd access log. This is the log. So from this log, I need to find that which IP has been accessed how many times. How to extract that? The first thing, you need to cat this. You need to cat this and find the. This is first letter, first word. This is second letter. This is the third word. This is the fourth word, right? So OKIT. This we have discussed last time also. Print $1. $1 print the IP address. $2 will print the second one. $3 that one. Fourth one, the November date will be there. When all it is accessed. So our concern is only about when it was. You can get the response also. What is the response? You want to find which are all the correct responses. How many 200 response we got? How many 400 response we got? How many errors we got? Like that. So the response comes here. So which is the number here? This is first one. This is second, third. This is fourth. Space is the delimiter. Okay. Fifth, sixth, seventh. 8, or most probably 9. That you need to count. Yeah, this is the. There is one 404. Right? So how to find it? How many 404 are there? Grep that starting with 4. How many are there? 1. How to find the count? Minus 3. You will get the output. How many are there? 2. Now if you want to 200 errors. 200 are not an error. How many are there? 3. You got my point? So this is how you write the script. This is a practical example. Now we'll do our task. I need to find the IP address and I will need to know how much times it accessed. Now I got the IP address. Now we need to get only the unique IP address. If you give awk minus c, awk minus e. What you will get? You will get the output of IP address, two IP address are there. I want only the IP address unique. So there is a command called unique. Unique. Okay, somebody is accessing here. See, some hacker is there. It's not me. Previously it was only 2, now it is 3. Okay. Okay, we'll find that. So we found it out unique. Now this should be given to some file. So we got the IP address. And using this IP address, we will find how many are there in the access log. Now, here you need to use loop for I in cat IP. What do we need to do? Do grep of $i into access log, var log httpd access log. You want to find the count. Find means you need to count minus c. C is count. Okay, you need to think on that. Then only you will be able to write this. Otherwise, no. Done. So I got 4, 1, and 1. It doesn't display the IP address. You need to display the IP address also. How to display the IP address? How to display the IP address? We will assign this to some value. Okay. Then keep getting better. We will write a script. Okay, we will write it in a one file. What is the file name? Count IPs dot sh. Insert. This is my code. I will write it in normal way. Do a equal to this one. So my count has been calculated by this logic. How many type of IPs? N. B is equal to the IP address, dollar I. And we echo it. Echo. What to echo? Dollar A, dollar B, and dollar A. What is the output now? What is the first line? It catches all the IP address. Okay, from that IP address, it checks in the access log. How many are there? Grab that IP address, count. So I store it in A. Then I store the IP address in B. So I want to output like this is the IP address and this is the count. And SH count dot addresses. What happened? Chmod plus X count addresses. Now count addresses. Why IP is not there? I will let you know. What is our first command? Cat IP. This is trying to cat from a variable. This is from a file. I have already executed one command here. See? This you can copy it into your script itself. Open it. Paste it. So what does it do? This is live now. Anytime it will calculate the new IPs. Cat completely awk one and give it to IP, and from that IP execute this dot count. See, four times, one time. Now I will try to access this again a number of times. Okay, without HTTPS. Will come all these things. Now we will try to count by cases. Everything changed. See? It came one more. That will try. What for?
For accessing
the
time.
Yes, that VPN IP will be here. And one more thing, we can get the origin IP also. That is actually. Then we'll get only the VPN IP. Exact source won't be fine. You won't get it. Okay, only VPN IP will come. That's the problem. But at least we can find that from VPN it is coming.
We can find that.
This is how, see, 14 hits has been come from this IP. Who is this IP? We can check it. You check this IP. Who is this IP? No, there's a command called who is. There's a command called who is. And give the IP address. Let me install. Who is not there? This is my local. Yes, who is there? I will use here. So who is will command will give you the IP address owner. Okay. It is at FiberNet. At least we can know it is given to, it is a act type. So we can complain directly to admin@corp.in. Okay, we can call them also. Their phone number will be also somewhere else. See, directly call them and complain from your IP address. And so from this output, you will be able to count how many IPs has been coming. This is a hit. This script is actually very useful. Okay. This type of question can be asked in interviews also. When you go to scripting, they will tell that this is a live question. Like from access log, I want to find the IP and the count. So this is the command. Either you by heart it or you understand. If you understand it, no issues. That's fine. Okay.
Okay.
So better always understand it, because this is not actually I have copy pasted from here. I just give you an example. I just created a script. So why I am able to create that? Because of logic of it. Only by understanding, right? So at least you should know what is what. That is the reason why we have studied cat and all. Cat, pipe, graph, everything we have used already. Now this practically we are using it. Okay. So as much as you can use this verb, you have some book for reference for this RSC and RSC?
Yeah,
that lab work is there?
Yeah.
You try lab work for scripting over there. Nothing is there. There is one second. We pause.